Hello everyone and welcome to St Matt's Sunday Club Online. A Happy New Year to you. I hope you've all had a lovely Christmas. Even though it has been a bit different this year, hasn't it, with the coronavirus. And I know lots of you will not have been able to see your grandparents and other family members and friends. But I hope you still had a good time. And we even had some snow, didn't we? It was only a sprinkling, but it's better than nothing. And I hope we get some more so we can make some really big snowmen. And now, of course, it's 2021. But Christmas is not yet over. So let's get off to a really good start this morning by singing one of our Christmas songs. You've all had great fun opening presents and playing with your new things over these last few days. I've played the board game I was given and I'm about to start this jigsaw. It's a picture of Paris and it has 1,000 pieces. So that'll keep me busy for a long time. I was also given this lovely beach towel. And so I'm already looking forward to going to the seaside in the summer. Now, part of the fun of Christmas is the giving and getting of presents, things that we will love and enjoy. But sometimes we're given things that aren't quite right. Maybe it's the wrong size, or it's a book or a game we already have. And so we need to swap them, take them back to the shop. It's just one of those things that happen. But every year, some gifts are not wanted at all. I don't want that, people say as they unwrap it. And so they take it to the charity shop or they sell it on eBay. They get rid of it. They don't want the gift. They want something better. Well, in the Bible, there is an unwanted present. Have a listen and see if you can work out what it is. At the time when Jesus was born, some magi, that is wise men, from the east saw a new star in the sky. They knew that it was a sign that a new king had been born. Now Herod was king in Judea, and so the wise men came to the city of Jerusalem and asked him, "Where is the child to be born king of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him. When King Herod heard about this, he was worried, and so gathered together the chief priests and the teachers and asked them, "Where will the Messiah be born?" "In Bethlehem, in Judea," they replied. "As it says in the prophecy given by God to the prophet Micah." When Herod heard this, he secretly called in the wise men and asked them when they had first seen the star. Then he told them, "Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, let me know. I want to go and worship him too." The wise men listened to what the king had said and then left and travelled on to Bethlehem. And there they found Jesus and worshipped him and gave him their gifts of gold, frankincense and myrrh. After they had seen Jesus, God warned them in a dream not to return to Herod. And so they went back home by another road, avoiding the city of Jerusalem. When the wise men had gone, an angel from the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up, hurry, and take the child and his mother to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you to return, because Herod is looking for the child and wants to kill him." That very night, Joseph got up and took Mary and Jesus on the long journey to Egypt. And they stayed there until Herod died. Now when Herod found that the wise men had tricked him, he was very angry. He gave orders for his men to kill all the boys who lived in or near Bethlehem that were 2 years old and younger. Well, that first Christmas, there was an unwanted present, wasn't there? Did you notice? Because the real Christmas story is about Jesus, the gift that God gives to every one of us. But not everyone wanted this present. King Herod didn't, did he? Because Herod didn't want Jesus because he wanted to be the only king. He was too proud and full of his own importance. So he tried to get rid of the gift. He tried to stamp on it and break it. And so Joseph had to take Mary and Jesus on a scary nighttime journey to the land of Egypt. And it was some time before they could actually return to their own home in Nazareth. But that wasn't the end of the danger for Jesus. All through his life, there were people who didn't want him. And the Bible tells us about these dangers. Did you know that one time when people heard Jesus speaking, they grabbed him and they took him to the top of a hill. They dragged him to the top and they tried to throw him off a cliff. And of course, the religious leaders, those who thought they knew all about God, well, they didn't want this gift either. Because they were angry when they heard Jesus talking about God. They were angry when they saw the amazing things that Jesus did. Because they wanted the people to follow them. They wanted to be the ones in charge. And so they decided to get rid of the gift. And so they captured Jesus, didn't they? And they killed him. The present sent by God was got rid of. It was not wanted. But of course, we know that they couldn't get rid of him, could they? Because on the third day, he came back to life and lives forever. So Jesus was and is the perfect gift. Because God knew exactly what we needed when he sent Jesus to our world. Because he knew that Jesus would help sort out all the mess in our lives. And he would show us how to be friends with God. And he would be someone that we could always trust, always rely on. Jesus would be able to help us deep inside. So Jesus is the perfect gift. There is nothing better. Now we've been given some great things this Christmas, but even our best presents will eventually wear out or break or become out of date, or we'll grow up and they'll be too young for us. Jesus is the perfect gift. He never wears out. He's never outdated. And our friendship with him will grow as we grow. We will never find anything better than Jesus.
He's just a baby. 10 fingers, 10 toes. 2 eyes, 2 ears. 1 mouth and 1 nose. He's just a baby. Cries out for mum's arms as he lies in a manger in the innkeeper's barn. He's just a baby, yet the sky changed its form as a new star appeared when this baby was born. He's just a baby, yet the hosts of heaven sang hallelujah to this baby, hallelujah, Son of Man. He's just a baby, yet drove a mad king wild, who stained the streets with innocence, looking for this child. Why? Because he's just a baby, yet will walk on the seas, feed thousands with nothing, and perform miracles with ease. He's just a baby, yet will carry out the law, live a life of perfection so man will fear no more. He's just a baby, yet will speak to every nation, every broken heart and lost soul, he will fight for their salvation. He's just a baby, yet when they call him man, they will shout for crucifixion and drive nails through his hands. He's just a baby, yet at his final breath, all creation will shake, mourning his death. He's just a baby, yet when he's laid in his grave, he will rise 3 days later, victorious to save. He is just a baby, when we look in his festive cot. But the truth is, he's not just a baby. He is the Almighty Son of God.
Now, when we get presents, we say thank you, don't we? And I expect some of you have started writing your thank you letters and thank you emails. Or maybe you said thank you to the person as they handed the gift to you. Well, the Bible says these words in the second letter of Corinthians, chapter 9, verse 15. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. Now, that means the gift of Jesus is so amazing, so wonderful, that it's hard to find words to describe him. And of course, the more we learn about Jesus, like here at Sunday Club, the more awesome we realise he is. So today, I thought we could say thank you to God. We would use these words as a shout to God of thanks. And then we'll give a round of applause. So let's have a practice and say it in our normal voices. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. Let's practice that again. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. And now we're going to shout that really loudly. Are you ready? Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. Yay! Now, when we're given special presents, we often put them somewhere where we can see them, maybe on a shelf or on our beds. And in the same way, we should keep Jesus at the centre of our lives, show that he is in a place of honour. Now we do that by following him, by obeying him, by trusting in him. That shows that we think God's gift is important. So for our second prayer, we're going to ask God to help us to do this. So when I say the words to keep, we're all going to say together, Jesus at the centre of my life. Let's have a practice. To keep Jesus at the centre of my life. Let's settle to pray. Dear Lord God, when I am at home, help me to keep Jesus at the centre of my life. When I am at school or nursery, help me to keep Jesus at the centre of my life. When I am alone or with friends, help me to keep Jesus at the centre of my life. And in everything I think and say and do, help me to keep Jesus at the centre of my life. Amen. Well, let us try to do that this year. Keep Jesus at the centre of our lives, because he is the Saviour, the Messiah, the greatest gift.
Jesus, sing to him today. Jingle, jingle, Jesus, trust him all the way. Savior, Messiah, let the good news ring. Jingle, jingle, Jesus, he's the King of Kings. Who's the baby in the manger down in Bethlehem? Who's the one who's sought out by the shepherds and wise men? Who's the child of promise bringing peace upon the earth? Who's got angels coming down to celebrate his birth? Jingle, jingle, Jesus, sing to him today. Jingle, jingle, Jesus, trust him all the way. Savior, Messiah, let the good news ring. Jingle, jingle, Jesus, he's the King of Kings. Good news for everyone on whom God's favour rests. He's the perfect Word of God living in the flesh. He's the Lord and Saviour who can rescue us from sin. There is no one better or more wonderful than him. Jesus, sing to him today. Jingle, jingle, Jesus, trust him all the way. Savior, Messiah, let the good news ring. Jingle, jingle, Jesus, he's the King of Kings. Savior, Messiah, let the good news ring. Jingle, jingle, Jesus, he's the King of Kings.
That's all for now. So I hope you have fun over the next few days playing with your presents. And as you do, remember that Jesus is the greatest gift given to you by God himself. Now, many of you will be starting school this week, and I pray that that will go really well and that you will have fun meeting up with your friends again. And next week, we're going to be thinking about this new year that we've entered, 2021, and we're going to be asking God to be with us this year. So I hope you'll join me then. Until then, take care, everybody. God bless you, and bye-bye.